Hey, how are you? I hope all are fine. So let's start our topic, milk and its composition. What is the definition of milk? Did you know? A whitish liquid containing proteins, fats, lactose, and various vitamins and minerals that is produced by the mammary gland of all mature female mammals after they have given birth and serves as nourishment for their young. So generally, milk contains all proteins, fats, lactose, and essential vitamins that is very essential for our body. A white or yellowish emulsion secreted by the mammary gland of female mammals for suckling their young and usually consisting of fats, proteins, useful sugars, vitamins, and minerals suspended in water. So let's talk about composition of milk. Okay, milk contains more water than any other element, around 87% for dairy cows. The other elements are dissolved, colloidally dispersed, and emulsified in water. The quantities of the main milk constituents can be varied depending on the individual animal or species, its breed, stage of lactation, age, and health status. So it's according to the species. Let's talk about composition of milk. Milk consists of water, total solids, fat, proteins, lactose, and minerals. So let's talk about all these constituents. So first we talk about milk fat. If milk is left to stand, a layer of cream forms on the surface. Did you see a layer of cream forms on the surface? It's called a fat. The cream differs considerably in appearance from the lower layer of the skim milk. Under the microscope, cream can be seen to consist of a large number of spheres of varying size floating in the milk. Each sphere is surrounded by a thin skin, and that's called the fat globule membrane, which acts as an emulsifying agent for the fat suspended in milk. The membrane protects the fat against enzymes and prevents the globules into butter grains. The fat is present as an oil in water emulsion. The emulsion can be broken by mechanical action such as shaking. So did you see at your home a layer of cream forms when you left a milk for some time? ठीक है, so आप एक देखते हो एक layer जो होती है cream की वो surface पर आ जाती है. उसी surface की layer को हम बोल देते हैं cream, और we have to say that it's a fat, milk fat. About 98% of milk fat is a mixture of triacylglycerols with much smaller amount of free fatty acids, mono and diacylglycerols, phospholipids, sterols, and hydrocarbons. Milk fat will also contain pigments like carotene, which give butter its yellow color. So yellow color is due to carotene and waxes. Milk fat act as a solvent for the fat-soluble vitamin A, D, E, and K, and also supplies essential fatty acids like linoleic acid, linolenic acid, and arachidonic. Next is milk protein. Milk protein consists of approximately 82% casein and 18% whey protein. Both casein and whey proteins are present in milk, yogurt, and ice cream. So there are two types of proteins that are generally present in milk, is casein and whey. In most cheeses, the casein is coagulated to form the curd, and the whey is drained, leaving only a small amount of whey protein in the cheese. During cheese making, the 6 casein is cleaved between specific amino acids and results in a unique protein fragment that is drained with the whey. Milk is approximately 3.3% protein and contains all the essential amino acids that is very essential for our body. Next is, we talked about casein. The casein is a group name for the dominant class of protein in milk. So there is an 88% of casein present in the milk, and left one is a whey. Normal bovine milk contains about 3.5% protein, okay, which casein constitute about 80%. Casein is easily separated from milk either by acid precipitation. We have to separate it by acid precipitation or by adding rennin on it. In cheese making, most of the casein is recovered with the milk fat. Casein can also be recovered from skim milk as a separate product. Whey protein. After the fat and casein have been removed from milk, one is left with whey, which contains the soluble milk salts, milk sugar, and the remainder of the milk proteins. So, like the protein in eggs, whey proteins can be coagulated by heat. It can be coagulated by heat. Next is milk carbohydrates. So their carbohydrates are also present in the milk. That is, milk is approximately 4.9% carbohydrate in the form of lactose. Carbohydrates are the primary source of energy. Glucose is the only form of energy that can be used by the brain. Excess glucose is stored in the form of glycogen in the muscles and liver for later use. Carbohydrates are important in hormonal regulation in the body because it gives energy to our body. Lack of adequate level of glucose in the blood and carbohydrate stores leads to muscles fatigue and lack of concentration. If we don't have a proper amount of glucose in our blood, so muscles fatigue faster. Lactose is a disaccharide made up of glucose and galactose bonded together before it can be used by the body. The bond must be broken by the enzyme lactase in the small intestine. People that have decreased activity of lactase in the small intestine may have problem at digesting lactose, and this is referred to as lactose intolerance or malabsorption. It means that some people have a problem to digest lactose. Okay? Like they have problem to digest milk, so they have called that lactose intolerance. Next is milk vitamins. Vitamins have many roles in the body, including metabolism, cofactors, oxygen transport, and antioxidant. One of the vitamins called thiamine is a water-soluble vitamin that is an enzyme cofactor involved in the metabolism of carbohydrates. Second vitamin is riboflavin, is a water-soluble vitamin that is an enzyme cofactor involved in electron transport reaction. Next one is a niacin. Niacin is a water-soluble vitamin that is an enzyme cofactor involved in electron transport reaction for energy metabolism. Next one is a vitamin D, is a fat-soluble vitamin that is important in maintaining blood calcium and phosphorus balance in our body. Vitamin K is a fat-soluble vitamin involved in the blood clotting, bone metabolism, and protein synthesis. Next one is the milk minerals. Minerals have many roles in the body, including enzyme functions, bone formations, water balance, maintenance, and oxygen transport. They help the body use carbohydrates, proteins, and fat. Calcium plays an essential role in bone formation and metabolism, muscles contractions, nerve transmissions, and blood clotting. Next one is a copper. Copper is a component of enzymes used in iron metabolism. Iron is a component of blood and many enzymes. It is involved in blood metabolism and oxygen transport. Magnesium. Magnesium is an enzyme cofactor and is important in bone metabolism. Magnesium is involved in bone formation and in enzymes involved in amino acid, cholesterol, and carbohydrate metabolism. Next one is a phosphorus. Phosphorus can maintain our body pH, so that's why it is very essential. Potassium is an electrolyte that is important in the maintenance of water balance, blood volume, and blood pressure in the human body. Zinc is a component of many enzymes and proteins and is involved in gene regulation. Thank you very much. Hope you like my video. So press the bell icon and subscribe my channel, Deepika Science Study Point.